right, time to chat with the stars. You know the new movie Superfly. It's a remake of the 70s film, the same name. It helped define a genre.
Yeah, and Fox 4's Shawn Edwards chats with the stars about introducing it to a new generation.
We're giving a new generation a piece of history.
You've got everything you could ever want. Culture, style, and of course, music. But if you look deeper, there's a whole other side you've never seen before.
How would you describe this? You're not reviving a classic or redoing a classic. What are we doing with this? What are we doing with this version of Superfly in 2018?
We're giving a new generation a piece of history. That's what this is, including myself. You know, before I got on to Superfly, I had to put on game from my grandparents what Superfly was and what it was about for them at that time.
I've been working these streets since I was 11. Gave people jobs when there were no jobs. I swapped cash for crypto and redefined the hustle.
For its time, being so powerful and having black people be highlighted as, you know, as fabulous, as Superfly, as, you know what I mean, in charge, bosses, can dress, have the money, the lifestyle, you know, for them, that was like a first, you know what I mean?
You've been operating under the radar. All of that's about to change.
You know what I love about you in this movie?
What's that?
Like, you as a woman, like, the role's been expanded for you in this newer version.
Yes.
How do you feel about that?
I love it. I think that what was okay and what existed in the 70s for women just simply wouldn't fly in 2018. So it was a huge responsibility for me to carry that role, because everyone's used to, you know, the 70s version, and it's just curious of how we were going to do it, and I can't wait for everyone to see it. But just to wear a new hat, a new dominance, to be amongst the men and be on the same playing field as the men.
One last score is so big that we will never have to look over our shoulder again.
Because the movie was primarily filmed in Atlanta.
Yes.
What was your favorite location where you shot in Atlanta, and why? And what was that entire vibe like each time on set?
We shot some scenes at Rick Ross's estate. And so there's a scene where I am meeting with Montenegro, getting paperwork, you know, ready for us to leave. And that was also, it was an office space in Rick Ross's home, and that was just beautiful. It's like one of those you had to be there and see it to believe it.
So he's a boss for real.
Oh, yeah.
Shawn Edwards, Fox 4 News.
Join us tomorrow in the Screening Room when Sean and Russ tell us what they think about movies opening in theaters this weekend, including Jurassic World.
Did you see Chris Pratt's speech, by the way?
No, I didn't.
Google that. It was awesome.
Okay.
We should play some of that. Hey, can you name the dance that uses two bamboo sticks? Bring in the bamboo! I've actually done this. I think I did this in elementary school. Anyway, we're going to learn all about it and see if we can shatter some ankles when